For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that how you can recover a graph failure, something like which is most of the people asking in the channel, that can you share the real time experience, or can you share the real time issues whenever something happens, what you have to do, or booting issues, all of this stuff. So out of that, so this is the name, one of the major breakout whenever the system is not booting up and which is landed into the grub console. So how you can recover, so which I am doing in a RHEL 8 version. So most of the times whenever you are doing this, is most of the steps are applicable for the RHEL 7 and RHEL 8 as well. So here I'm having the CentOS 8 machine here. So I would like to show you that how the grub can be misconfigured, or something happened to the grub and your system is not able to boot, then which is land into the grub console, then you have to recover from the grub console, then you have to bring back your system back to online. So how you can do that? So let's start simulating the issue. So how we can launch into the grub? So whatever the reason, you may be launching into the grub console, but here I'm just deleting the grub configuration file so that you will launch into the grub whenever you reboot the system. So simply I'm just going head slash boot grub to grub.cfg file. So this is the file, I'm just dropping it here. So now the grub configuration file has been deleted from the system. So whenever I reboot the system, what happens? It will land into the grub console. So just try to reboot the system here. So the system has been issued a reboot. Now you can see that. So you have landed into the grub console. So here, what you can do here. So example, see here what you can do. So here there is a simplest way, is that you can simply restore this configuration from the rescue mode. So what I'm going to do here is that I'm just going into the VMware settings and connect this ISO here, okay, and exit from the grub console. So here I landed into the DVD media, booting with the DVD media, because I set my booting priority as boot first into the DVD. So here I'm just entering into the troubleshooting and rescue the CentOS Linux system. So here what it will do here, it is that it will give us an rescue mode to recover the system. So the system is landing into the installers, and you can see that. So there are few options which you wanted to utilize here. So you wanted to skip to shell directly, or you wanted to see a read-only mount point, or quit from the and reboot the system, or you wanted to continue with the rescue mode. So I want to continue with the rescue mode, so I just choose the option one, and now which is saying that you can use the system image mounted under the sys image so that you can get the shell here. So this is the shell, I got it here. So now what I have to do is that I have to change this console, or make it as in a root environment to, in order to execute the some root privileged commands. So I'm just changing the slash root slash mnt slash sys image. So now I gotten a root shell here. So what you have to do is that, so in order to recover, so whatever is has been done, maybe something happened to your grub, so you have to reinstall the grub. So in order to do that, grub to install /dev/sda. So hoping that your grub has been installed by default on the first device /dev/sda, then you have to pointing out this to install your grub. Otherwise, if you have some virtual device, as example, that VDA, something like that, so you have to point out that device to install the grub. So now the installation has been finished here, so which is no report has been issued here as of now. So if you have any EUFI, maybe a EFI grub, like UEFI grub based machines, example, so then you have to do a different way, that you have to reinstall the grub to EFI and grub EFI modules to install compile the grub to configuration. So but here mine is not the UEFI boot devices, so I'm just using the a normal BIOS system here. So in order to run the configuration, so you have to run this grub to configuration to compile, so making the grub to configuration, so grub to make configuration and provide the output device where it is exactly. So /boot grub.cfg. So this is the file we have deleted, and we are regenerating the grub configuration file using the grub to make config. So which will recreate the grub configuration file in order to boot your system. Sorry, so there is a mistake in a command. So this is what you have to do, generating the grub configuration file. So now you can see that the grub configuration has been successfully regenerated. So now what you have to do, exit from this chroot and reboot your machine and see whether you can able to get into the system or not. So now exit from here and again exit from here, so which will automatically reboot your system and try to log into your machine. So example, see whether we could able to get the console back or not. Let's see it. So now you can see that the system looks to be loading, so it may take a few minutes to load. So now the system has been loaded successfully. So let's connect using this PuTTY again. So restart this session back. So now provide the password, successfully logged in, and go to /boot and c grub to, and you can see that there is a grub configuration file has been regenerated. Maybe you can see the date when it is regenerated or last modified is this date. So this way you can simply use that the grub configuration to rebuild and change the grub configuration so that your system will be recovered from grub console to the system has been reconstructed whenever you have a reboot the grub issues or something like that. So this way you can set your grub back and recover it. Otherwise you can also set your boot device device path and just access the temporary console, and you can also, if you have any /boot backup, and restore it back so that your system will be restored back as well. So that way also you can do, there is another method also you can do, but most of the times you can, the rescue mode would be in a very very useful to use it to rescue your system. So that's about it guys for this video. So please join the WhatsApp group or Telegram group if you wanted to discuss something related to any issues on your environment, or if you wanted to get some help from the other techies, like on the certification part, on the career part, or if you have any questions while doing something. So if you have a point of question, you can ask the other techies so that exchange knowledge in between the group of people, so that your your knowledge will be improved and others group members' knowledge also will be improved. So the tech is maybe share the documents they have, or you can maybe share the documents you have with the other group, so that each other will be collaborated together. You will get the good exposure to the environment or the real-time issues, anything happens, or job searching also will be helpful on these groups. So most of the 1,000 to 2,000 people almost joined in the Telegram groups and WhatsApp groups. So if you wanted to part of it, so I have given the link on the description. You can simply click on that and join the groups. That's up to it, guys. If you do not subscribe the channel already, press the subscribe button and activate the bell icon to get the latest notification on the latest uploaded videos.